Hello friends, welcome to my channel. I am Nidhi and today we will learn how to make a perfect chapati dough using KitchenAid Stand Mixer without scraping the sides. Before we begin, I want to request you all, if you are new to my channel, then please do subscribe to my channel. Also click on the bell icon so you never miss another update, and let's get started. I have here this KitchenAid Stand Mixer and this dough hook attached on it. Now add 3 cups of whole wheat flour. I'm using Ashirvad atta here. Here goes the second and third one. Now add little bit of salt. This is optional. And add around 1 teaspoon of oil. I'm using olive oil here. Now lock the mixer and keep the speed on 2 initially. Now let it mix everything well together for around 30 seconds. And now we will add 1.5 cup of water. So this is 1 cup of water. Now make sure to pour the water on edges and not in the middle. This will avoid dough sticking on the edges, and later you no need to scrape the dough on the sides. Now after adding 1 cup of water, keep the speed on 4 now and add rest of the water. So now this is 1/2 cup of water. As soon as the dough start coming together, increase the speed. Now sometime what happens is the dry flour left behind on bottom. So if this happens, turn off the mixer and add around 2 to 3 teaspoons of water onto a dry flour. Now keep the dough hook onto the dough and start mixing it again. Now you can see all the dough has come together. So at that point we will add 1 teaspoon of oil to smoothen it out. Now turn on the mixer and knead the dough for around 30 seconds on medium speed. Now if you want really soft the chapati, then it is necessary to form gluten in your dough. So in that case, after dough comes together, start kneading it for another 1 to 1.5 minute. This will really help to soften out the dough and you will really get soft rotis. It took me around 3.5 to 4 minutes in order to get this really soft dough. So now turn off the mixer and you can see here we have our soft dough ready. If you are kneading it for a little bit longer time, then you really don't need to rest the dough. And you can prepare chapati as soon as you finished making dough in your mixer. If you think that this video was helpful to you, then don't forget to give a thumbs up to this video and share with your families and friends. Thank you for watching and I will see you soon with the next recipe.